Hi, I'm Freddie Andersky with Bendix, and we're going to continue and wrap up our conversation with school bus drivers about some of the concerns and questions they had about the Bendix ESP, Bendix Wingman Advanced, and Bendix Wingman Fusion systems. What we're going to get into now is excessive beeping. Our old buddy, the Roadrunner here, beeping. And beeping is a sign from the system that you're getting close to the vehicle in front. Now, it would help for us to start with, let's talk about some of the alerts that we deliver with the system first. There are following distance alerts, what we call FDAs. And following distance alerts are really the alerts that are letting you know that you're getting closer to that vehicle in front of you. And basically, below 37 miles an hour, you typically get two alerts, a closer, closest alert, and above 37 miles an hour, you'll usually get three alerts, a close, closer, closest alert. Okay? And again, those alerts are there to let you know that you're getting close to the vehicle in front. So if you're getting a lot of alerts, a lot of following distance alerts, well, a couple of things that you can do. Well, first of all, as we talked about before, just back off a little bit, and that'll make the alert go away. Because again, the alert is giving you a heads up that the system thinks you're getting close and maybe something could happen. By backing off a little bit, you can turn off, the alerts will go away, and you're probably in a better situation should something unexpected happen in front of you. Now, the other alert we provide is what we call the impact alert. And the impact alert, really these three red bars up here and a good loud noise, lets you know that the system's determined that a collision is imminent, okay? That you might have a crash situation. And basically, we give that alert a half second before we cut your throttle and apply the brakes, because we want to get you back into the game to help avoid what could be a pretty bad situation. So that's the impact alert. Another alert that we provide is the stationary object alert. This alert lets you know that maybe there's a metallic object of size in your lane of travel. And it gives you an up to 3 seconds heads up so you can either slow or turn, swerve to avoid that potential. So the following distance alert, impact alert, and stationary object alert are part of both the Wingman Fusion and the Wingman Advanced systems. But Wingman Fusion goes a step further. Because we have the camera, we can provide alerts that the camera can see. We talked about speed sign recognition, where the system will give you an alert if you're going 5 miles an hour over the speed limit, 10 miles an hour over the speed limit, an alert, and a 1 second de-throttle. So you get audio, visual, and haptic alerts there. And we can also see those lane lines in the road. So if you happen to drift a little bit out, we can give you a lane departure warning. Now, lane departure warning is available above 37 miles per hour, and it is one of the alerts that you can actually switch off. You can actually turn it off for 15 minutes. The alert we give is a rumble strip alert. If you drift to the right, get rumble strip to the right, drift to the left, rumble strip to the left. And those, again, are fusion specific. So as we talk about the alerts, you know, if our old buddy the Roadrunner is giving you problems and you're feeling you got too much alerts, well, first of all, like we talked about, try backing off, because the alert is letting you know that you're getting too close. The other thing that you can do too is, in your particular situation, maybe the alert strategy that's being used on your bus isn't the right one for your particular situation. So talk with your fleet manager and see if it makes sense to maybe change that alert strategy for your route to be able to help reduce those alerts. The one thing that you don't want to do is do not tamper with the system at all, okay? Back off, don't tamper. You'll be in good shape then. Now, volume, you remember our stereo over here? Volume control is one of those big questions if you feel that your alerts are getting or are too loud. Now, on the driver interface unit, we do have a volume control, but not all OEMs will make that available to you. So you can check on the DIU if you don't have volume control. That is something that the original manufacturer of the bus can help you determine. So you may want to talk to your dealer if you feel your volume is too loud. So throughout this series, we've talked about a lot of different technologies. We talked about stability technology, Bendix ESP, which is designed to help you, the driver, mitigate rollover and loss of control situations. We also talked about Wingman Advanced, our radar collision mitigation system, and Wingman Fusion that combines both the radar and works with the camera to help deliver collision mitigation as well as alerts and interventions to be able to help you. One technology, though, that we should talk about before we leave our session is air disc brake technology. Air disc brakes are great technology. We use them on all our demo vehicles, and the reason why we use them on our demo vehicles is because they deliver superior stopping distance performance as well as less fade than drum brakes. Now, drum brakes are still good. Nothing wrong with drum brakes, but you do a lot of stop and go. And the more stopping and going that you do, that can heat up the brakes. And with a drum brake, when the drum heats up, it actually expands away from the friction material. And this is what causes fade. And fade can reduce your stopping distance when you apply the brake, and it may also impact when the collision mitigation system applies the brake as well. An air disc brake utilizes a rotor that actually is surrounded by the friction material. So as the rotor heats up, it actually expands towards the friction material, and that's why we get virtually no fade with air disc brakes. Plus, they are a lot easier to work on too, the drum brakes. So, we're seeing more and more disc brakes out in the marketplace. It's a great technology that complements both stability control and collision mitigation. And give them a try, you may like them. So that wraps up the sessions that we've had on the various questions that came up from some of our school bus drivers that we've talked to. If you do have more questions, don't hesitate to reach out to us, and we'll update this as we get more insight and such. Thank you for your time and attention. Have a great day. Stay safe out on the road.